earlier last week when I drove with my fellow friends and my fellow students about 6.5, 7 hours to get to my state capitol to meet with those representatives that put these laws in place that allowed this shooting to happen. I met with three. We had a full day of meetings set up. Representative after representative refused to meet with us. We were not there for the media. We were not there to speak to reporter after reporter. As nice as the news cycle has been, they are not the ones that can cause the law to change. They are not the ones that can write those laws. We went there, and I sat in the House of Representatives of Tallahassee, and I sat and watched these people speak about "In God We Trust." And I will say, I do not know what God I can trust that will allow this to happen time and time again. It was Valentine's Day, February 14th, my sister's birthday. She will never have another normal birthday again because of these weapons of war, because of these weapons of violence that are allowed in not only our schools, but our society. They should be stopped. I'm not here as a politician. I am not here to be above the people. I am here to speak with you today. I am here to speak face to face with anybody who comes up to me. I hope to say I'm approachable. If I don't seem like I am, I'm sorry. But I am here to say that I do not want to rip the guns out of anybody's hands. If you are able-bodied, if you are willing to take the time to learn how to use the weapon, and you are fully trained and have the proper permits, you shall be allowed to have that weapon and you have every right. But if you are not fit to hold that weapon, you should not have one. I come here and I speak to you as just one person, as one student who faced this tragedy. But I will say, there are over 3,000 others who have gone through this, just like me. And they are all there in Parkland and going around the country just to speak with fellow people. Does not matter if you are a legislator. Does not matter if you are a member of the media. I do not care who you are. If you are willing to sit down and talk, if you disagree with me, if you believe that you do not want a single regulation on guns, I would just like to take a seat and talk this out with you. I know there have been people out there calling us crisis actors, calling David Hogg, who is here with us today. He was called a 27-year-old man who has gone through facial reconstruction from the FBI. Now, I don't know exactly what the FBI does, but I know if they're doing that, they're surely wasting their time. Because it does not matter how much you reconstruct a person's face, their acting ability does not change. And I know I'm invoking laughter from the crowd, and I know that I'm smiling up here, and that I may not seem like I'm a student who is grieving. I may not seem like a student who is sad. I'm angry. But it does not matter, for I am a comedian, and more so, I am a busboy. 2 weeks before this, I was at Runyon's restaurant, picking up dishes, folding napkins. And now I'm here being compared to the Freedom Riders. I did not see this coming. But I'm here where we can cause just as much change, where we can shake society. Society is not concrete. It is as concrete as a block of Swiss cheese. And as we've seen with such loopholes as the gun show ones, we can change them, and we just have to speak up. As my brother had mentioned, we are marching March 24th in Washington, and I hope to see you there.